on the audio and the desktop audio, and welcome to the episode zero of on the our audio, on the audio and the desktop audio, desktop audio, and welcome and our
that's
audio,
what I get for not testing everything.
There we go, much better. Welcome to episode zero of our
what I get for.
Why do I have duplicates? Where the hell is my channel? Oh. There we go. Last try. Go figure. Alright, what did I do with my thing? Welcome to episode zero of The Sprawl. Our game is currently unnamed because we haven't really developed the world yet, which is what this episode is for. I am Steel Seraph. I am the Game Master. Below me is Blake Stare, as he likes to be known at the moment, Vid Wizard, Shane, and Garrett is not right here right now, so filling in for him is Professor Fig. Welcome. The board's not up yet because I'm still making this scene as we're going along, so feel free to introduce yourself and who you are and what you're looking forward to in this game whilst I play around with OBS for a little bit.
Isn't DOS Kid, isn't that Garrett?
No, that's me.
Wrong DOS Kid.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, that looks like, you know what, I'm really glad I left that space between the sprawl and your name.
Yeah, it worked beautifully for that.
Hmm. Yeah, it worked really well. Now, if you want, I can put a shadow there. I can just put, like, a light, dark shadow so that it's, like, just a little darker on the background there. I just like make a shadow so that it sits underneath it.
I'm not super worried, but we'll work it out. Although now you get to look at the window for the game for a moment whilst I hate the fact that I can't just do a quick crop. I have to do it by the numbers, which is really annoying.
Well, that's fine.
Left, I want to do 100. There we go.
And you have the ability to do font colors, by the way.
Oh, that's too much. 125. There we go. Bottom. Let's do 100. And right. 800. Hey, there we go. This needs to go under the. Where the hell is the. Oh my god, I have so many layers. Under the overlay. Okay. Nope. That's not going to work. I'm going to have to shrink it down a little bit more. But, actually, that's not bad.
You're probably going to have to trim off the bottom, basically, I think is the way that this ends up working, because it's...
I'll just put the players over it, and then it won't be an issue. Boom! Perfect.
Nice.
I actually like the way that looks. From there, I need to do chat, which is going to be a little bit more complicated. But let's add another window capture. I'm just going to have to keep that window open all the time because if I create a new window of a different size, it's going to F everything all up. This is going to be in-game chat. So I was really going to open this up to try and figure out what you guys are looking for in a cyberpunk game. Because cyberpunk has everything from kind of the Shadowrun level of magic and craziness, which this game doesn't really support, so if you want magic, I apologize in advance. They have a add-on coming for that eventually, but for the time being, this is more going to be humans, disparate future, mega corporations. Government pretty much doesn't exist except for as a puppet of said mega corporations. Whole nine yards on that variety.
Gotcha. So what year, 2018?
Yeah, pretty much. We're going to go with there is no definitive year, so we can have tech of weird varieties. One of the big things, especially when during character generation, is you have a piece of cyber tech in your body by default at start. And that links you to the companies or puts you in debt by virtue of you had to pay for it somehow.
Gotcha.
What am I looking for here? So I'm kind of looking to see what you guys are interested in exploring in terms of what am I looking for? In terms of, like, are you looking more to be bad guys? Are you looking more to be anti-heroes? Are you looking more to be theoretically heroes, though that doesn't really work in cyberpunk? Cyberpunk is basically noir, so heroes don't really exist all that much in noir without getting their asses whooped all the time.
Gotcha.
Oh, that's too far.
Excuse me.
1980? I can't tell if I've cut off too much. Other than that, it's really up to you guys. This is going to be me facilitating almost as much as it is you guys playing.
Okay.
If that makes any sense. And then kill about, what, 100? 150? Yeah, there we go. Perfect. Push this down. Under the overlay, so it goes right here.
Sorry.
I hear a cat.
Yeah,
she's letting me go. Kitty.
And your audio seems to be going again, just as a warning.
Going in and out, or?
Yeah, roboting again.
Tinny.
Put it under the players just in case. Cool. So, the biggest conceit of this game is, like all Powered by the Apocalypse games, I can get the book in the square, there we go. It's run by clocks. When there's no ticks in the clock, everything's good. When it goes to 3 o'clock, it starts to get worse. Then 6, it gets worse still. Until eventually you get to midnight and the shit hits the fan. That's why all of these have a clock of 15, 18, 20, or 21, 22, 23, and midnight. In the case of the legwork and action phase, those are based on each mission. Legwork is what you're doing before you start taking on the mission itself, trying to figure out where something is, what they're doing, etc. As the legwork clock ticks on, that's how much your target knows you're looking for them, basically, for lack of a better term. Either, you know, your target knows you're looking for them, or the corporation knows you're planning something, that sort of thing. The action clock is how much response said enemy will bring to bear upon you, from as little as, you know, being completely unaware as you're coming, so it's a very light response, to full military response. And once the action clock hits 0, the mission is over. You've lost.
Did you screw up when I refreshed?
Oh, you sound fine.
Right, but I'm now over where...
Oh, that's easy to fix. Conveniently enough. you go here, if I remember correctly. Yep, and then he goes here, and boom. Easy peasy. So, from there, we've also got corporations. Those don't reset after each mission. Those are cumulative. Over time, you'll be doing missions that will probably involve corporations. Either they'll be on the opposite side of working against you, or they'll be ancillary, you know, players in the background. And as time goes on and you start pissing them off more, it's something along the lines of at 3 o'clock they're noticing you, or at 3 o'clock they know something, you're an ephemeral somebody is after you. At, you know, 9 they have an idea of who you are. At 10 and 11 they're starting to send assets against you, and at midnight they're harassing you all the time. So there are ways to reduce those clocks with missions and other ideas, but that's the straightforward basic example of it. As well as, over time, you might collect other enemies like individual people or gangs or other minor players. They'll also get their own clocks, but you won't see them. I will. other than that, is there any things outside of corporations, which we'll discuss next, that you're looking to explore in Cyberpunk that I can make sure, like, you know, some elements of Cyberpunk is a heavy drug culture, it's a heavy gang culture, it's a heavy... Let me know what bits and pieces you guys are looking for that I can build into this.
Okay.
Cool. I'm done spouting out a bunch of words.
I don't know. So many different visions of Cyberpunk in my head. I've always been really partial to the Blade Runner universe, though. So, I mean...
Well, it's like...
I like the synth aspect of it. I like that... Well, it's something that, like, in Blade Runner, Ghost in the Shell, all those, I really like the diving into what, where do you draw the line between what is human and what, you know, when not.
Yeah. I grew up on a combination of Ghost in the Shell and Snow Crash.
Okay.
If you've not read Snow Crash, it's an amazing book, but is kind of borderline on the parody level of Cyberpunk, because the main character's name is Hero Protagonist, and he's a cyber ninja pizza delivery guy. So,
oh god, that's awesome.
That's kind of the level of interesting that setup is. Something to be aware of there. You're muted, Jim.
I scrambled the video again. Sorry.
Nope, it's all good. It's easy to fix. That's why I like this over Zoom, because I can just drag all y'all around and you're back in the right places.
I was setting my thing to be better quality, so hopefully it stopped roboting on me.
Yeah.
Cool.
Other than that,
I like the Blade Runner aspect, but I'm also, as for Cyberpunk, as me, for me personally, it's always about playing with the cybernetics.
Oh yeah, well, cybernetics are definitely going to be a big part of it. Some of the things that have also been explored that I liked, the developer of this game actually runs a stream every once in a while of like introducing aspects, customizing the game further for different stories and whatnot. And one of them he did was a short film that he basically tore apart and was like, what elements of this can I use actually in the Sprawl? And he developed this, like, your consciousness is downloadable and you can have an insurance policy that will buy you a new body and put you in it with all your memories leading up to the point of your download in it. And it was pretty interesting to watch. I highly recommend you look up his stream, and I will link it later this evening as something to take a look at as well. Oops, there we go. Properties.
You know, you have a white bar there, right?
Yeah, I'm working on that right now. I was zooming it out so it gets a little bit more showing.
Yeah.
Left side crop, 150. Boom! All gone. Kinda, except now it's on this side. There we go. Now we're playing with gasoline here. So, other than that, I'm definitely cybernetics is definitely a big thing going into it. I like with hacking, there's a lot of VR involved, so depending on if anyone wants to play hacker, there will probably be VR elements as well. I haven't heard your guys' ideas one way or the other, so that will be coming in step one. First and foremost, though, is there any other elements you're looking for in terms of what you'd like to include, what cool things you want to do, etc., that I should know beforehand? I'll take from the blank stares that the answer is no, so it's all good there.
That's my trademark move.
Yep.
Yeah, you're going to be a blank stare for a reason.
Exactly. Alright. From there, let's move to step zero. If you've got the game book, it is on page 48. Defining the corporations. Each player, including myself, names and briefly describes a megacorporation for an entire entity of similar scope, like an organized crime syndicate or a government. We can't include governments in this. The level of detail of description may vary depending on taste of group, taste of player, and type of game. We're doing more of a hopefully long-term game, so we can explore spheres of interest, organizational goals, corporate divisions, iconic locations, secret facilities. We can go really deep into each of these, and I am more than happy to include any and all. If we want, I can start off. As you can see, I kind of already put one up there. If you haven't worked out based on the logo, I made it Alpha X, Alpha being the first half of the Google parent company Alphabet, and the X being the X from SpaceX, mostly because my research turned out, if you've ever actually looked up the Wikipedia page for Elon Musk, he runs like six different companies that all scream cyberpunk to me. He's got a brain computer interface company, he's got an AI company, he's got a space company, and he's got a self-driving car company. All those scream like future to me. So I felt the merger between that and Google fit pretty well in making a conglomerate, almost a, they make like 85% of the things both inside you and in your house. Not maybe the luxury level, but the consumer level of everything. They're the basic cyberware installed in you as a child. They're the, you know, oh, you've broken an arm and need a basic cyber arm. That's what they built. They're the, oh, your house needs automation. We'll build a simple AI to run your entire house. That sort of thing. That's Alpha X in my envisioning in a nutshell. The other thing I meant to catch before we went onto this, but regardless, works for this anyways. Where did you guys want this to take place? I can run it basically anywhere because it's the future. It's going to change. But if you have a particular location you'd like me to explore, I can look up details and build them into it. Otherwise, I know California the best, and I would probably default it to California.
The shower thought I had the other day was San Fran, Tokyo.
That's a possibility, too.
The Hero 6.
Yeah, I love it.
It won't be that pretty, though.
Well, no, it'll be the gritty version of it, which I would actually really love to explore.
Yeah, I'm totally down with some... I'm trying to think of how best to link those two locations together easily. I have an idea of maybe a arcology off the coast of the Bay Area is where they basically relocated a greater portion of the Tokyo metro area because, I don't know, we'll explore what happened to the Japanese islands somehow. So that way there's kind of that mesh of the Bay Area and the Tokyo area together kind of in this amalgamation, unless y'all have other explanations you want to add into. I want to build this with you guys.
I mean, if we want to go realistic, they're worried about the Great Kanto Area earthquake coming up pretty soon.
Yeah,
that could be a Japan splitting event in theory.
And it could have happened with them getting enough time to be like, okay, let's just move the city.
Yeah.
So I'm down with that if that's all right with you guys.
Sounds like fun.
Yeah, I like that idea.
Yeah, cool. We can build that in. And that makes it easier for making a form of headquarters for Alpha X. I can see it as like a massive offshore campus style island thing. Maybe even part of the bridge between the Bay Area and the Tokyo arcology as a, like, you know, they funnel in all their workers to that one central location.
Yeah, they control access. That'd be cool.
Yeah.
So I just put... am I muted? No.
Nope. You're good.
I just put in the Discord channel, I just put the name for my corp.
Discord channel. Gekido Prime. All right, Jim, tell me about Gekido Prime.
They are a private security company.
Ooh, I like it already.
They are high end. They're basically, the Pinkertons of this time period, for lack of a better term. They're a private security company. They do everything from protecting stuff to tracking down stuff.
Nice.
So, are you familiar with the Pinkertons from in the 1800s?
Yes.
Okay. So think of that in this time period. Same basic job functions.
Kakito Prime.
So obviously they were they're inspired by the San Fran Tokyo kind of aspect.
Nice. That will be an interesting, probably, although depending on how you build your character, you might be an ex-employee thereof or owned by them depending on how things play out. So I should probably be doing notes here.
And as a side note, Gekido is the game that I was demoing at Gen Con.
Mm-hmm.
That is actually inspired by the first 10 minutes of Big Hero 6.
Nice.
So tie it back to Big Hero 6 again.
Cool.
So besides them being, let's see here, working for security firm. Do you see them more as being in the security industry? I understand more of... I gotta follow. I gotta wait for it to actually show.
Nice.
Do you see it as... Why did it... Oh, I'm being hosted. Never mind. Thank you for the host, Vic.
Also cool.
Do you see it as contracted out to the corporations in more of a... We provide the security for all your companies, or more of a hunt and peck as needed style group?
Both. Two different divisions, basically.
Corporate security and...
Yeah. So they provide security, they provide security for, you can hire them to be security for your building, or, if something's gone missing, you can hire their search and, search and retrieval division or other divisions that aren't on the books.
Ooh, I'm looking forward to exploring their more Black Ops divisions. So kind of like a mix between, say, Securitas and Blackwater.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, if you've done any research on what the Pinkertons did during the 1800s, they were at one point considered law enforcement, and then at one point they were more bounty hunters, and then at one point they were like the go-to for security, bank security and stuff.
Yeah.
So I mean, they evolved over time, and that's kind of the same thing, like you said, like a little bit of Blackwater, so their outward facing, is corporate security and, retrieval, and legal retrievals, but they clearly have, the size of the company and the amount of money they have, clearly they have an underground Black Ops division that'll do things like start wars or, topple other corporations.
Awesome. Apparently they still exist. They're owned by Securitas now. I was curious.
Who's that?
Pinkerton.
Yeah,
Pinkerton Detective Agency still exists. It's owned by Securitas.
Yep.
That's funny.
Yeah.
That is something that I am only acutely aware of because I work in the security industry.
You use the other font for the title?
Oh, yeah, for the time being, it's just the easiest grab, because,
No, it's fine,
Roll 20 actually has a very limited amount of fonts, so...
Right, no, I was saying that in the
Oh, I'm the just... Name, I would drink just one a font. Filler.
Yeah. No, just I was just gonna say, the Steel Seraph looks good, but we should add a little color to the players, and then I would say shrink the font by one...
Yeah.
One size, just because it... like Blank Stare and Steel Seraph is really full.
Yep. What can you tell me about what runs the company? CEO, is it a dark board, is it I don't know, for comparative purposes, I see Alpha X being run by an AI. It may have a front facing person, so you don't know it's run by an AI, but Alpha X's CEO is basically a AI, probably combination of what's the head honcho at Google, a combination of him, Larry, and Elon.
Yeah, so
Larry Musk.
You know, Gekita would be run by basically, you know, it had started as and has always been run by a particular family. I'll have to give you a name and stuff later, but
okay.
Basically, it's a family legacy or dynasty, basically. You know,
interesting.
Father, daughter, brother, you know, like the family members are in key places in, you know, in all sorts of layers. So, you know, the family is large and diverse. And so it's not, you know, there's a patriarchal character, I mean, male or female, that's kind of the CEO, but like the board is nearly entirely cousins and aunts and uncles and, you know, nephews and sons and daughters.
Awesome. All right. So I'm looking forward to exploring how they mesh in pretty nicely into this. Will or Shane, which one of you wants to go next?
I can go next.
Go for it.
All right, so my idea for the company, they're called Shinhan Financial Management.
Spell that.
And that's definitely their biggest. Shinhan, S-H-I-N-H-A-N.
New word or single same word?
New word. There's okay. the same word. Shinhan's the same word. And
okay.
Financial management. And so, like, their biggest business is definitely, like, banking, investment, and that kind of stuff. But I'm drawing a little bit on Korea. I lived there for 2 years. And those companies, like the big family companies over there, they just get involved in like everything. And it's different than here. Like Elon Musk has 6 companies, but they're all tech related kind of, right?
Yeah.
This company, they have their hands in like just a disparate, they have, there's like a Shinhan apartment complex and they are here and there, and like they're involved in like the entertainment and propaganda industry, so they have like an entertainment studio that they put out music for and other kind of like entertainment stuff, and they'd probably come into contact a little bit with Alpha X, but they wouldn't be a like a major direct competitor to Alpha X. They would be, you know, involved in some like some smaller areas of the tech business that they may have competing products, but they're not going to be like full-on competitors.
Okay, so I'm seeing it a general goods tech.
I would say their core business is like financial dealing and banking,
mm-hmm.
And they've kind of used that like monetary platform just to branch out, and they have like subdivisions that are involved in. And lots of different things. Like there's like a Shinhan like home cooking brand where they like make, you know, whatever, woks and
yeah,
and home grills and that kind of stuff. And they kind of like trying to move into like a whole like lifestyle type thing. But those are definitely like backseat to the banking and financial industry. That's probably pretty sketchy.
Nice. Let's see, sketchy. Financials. Awesome. I like that. How do you see the company being run? Similar to how Gekito's run?
Yeah. There's a CEO, but it's definitely familial, and it's passed down. But unlike what we were talking about earlier, there's not like a broad like cousins, uncles, aunts. It's like there is a small core family that is at the CEO level. And they control everything. There is no board. There's no investors that would have like a stake in it or say it's controlled by one like nuclear family.
Nice.
At the CEO level.
And
then they have, you know, they obviously they have like people that work for them.
Sense.
Where is my? Excuse me while I be all disorganized here because my brain's fried after a long day at work.
What is the most illegal thing that Shinhan's doing right now?
The most illegal thing?
Yes.
I mean, they're doing lots of, like, semi-illegal things, and they have a nice, like, propaganda arm to do it. And in fact, that's what a lot of their, like, rebranding and sub products are, right? Like, how can you hate the company that built your apartment complex? But, like, they're doing all sorts of, like, illegal banking and, like, money laundering and investing in all sorts of stuff that they don't report. Like subprime mortgage derivative reinvesting, but like times 100. Like it's, awesome. It's basically a house of cards. Like if you started pulling one or two cards out from their like financial dealings without them knowing, it would go down. But like as of right now, it's this massive empire.
Yeah, I could definitely see like Alpha X and Shinhan. Not necessarily overtly going against each other, but always, like, trying to pick at each other.
Yeah, yeah. Because, like, I'm sure they share some sectors where they intersect.
Yeah.
With their, like, products and stuff, but...
Awesome. All
but,
right.
Like, I don't think it's, like, a like, Macintosh Windows type thing.
Yeah.
You know, it's not that head-to-head.
It's more of, I would say, Alpha X kind of sees some of the more general goods that Shinhan produces being maybe, you know, oh, that's less than us. We don't have to worry about that part.
Oh, yeah.
But some of their other stuff, like, but their financials are starting to pick at us, so we're going to start picking back at that. All right, Mr. Blank Stare. Since you're rocking your blank stare there, tell me about your corporation.
I'm still trying to come up with a name, but so my concept is it's an energy company and it's a massive conglomerate. It's like one of those major mergers where 20 different companies have come together to create this gigantic, overarching trust monopoly beast. That just does everything energy.
Makes sense.
And raw, and it's just fully vertically and horizontally integrated across the board. So I'm trying to think. I was thinking like maybe take two existing companies and hyphenate them like a Sanyo Shell or something like that.
That's actually one of the ways they recommend making a corp in the book. So feel free to explore that. So let's go with unnamed Blanks Corporation for the time being, whilst I write down my notes here. You're looking for an energy... how about energy and heavy industry?
Yeah.
So they're like the mining corporation, the industrial complex, basically.
Oh yeah, definitely. They're probably doing asteroid mining in orbit and that kind of shit, too.
Oh, that wouldn't surprise me.
We're up there. We're in space. I don't know. We'll have to see.
We don't have to explore space, but if you guys want to take it that way, that's entirely possible too. I don't want to steal from the Roll 20 game, but I can see this as a corporation that might have a like or well, I don't want to take from your company, so feel free to explore further.
I'm open for a suggestion too because I like that.
I liked the Roll 20 Sprawl game. They have a corporation that has this like monolithic sized offshore barge that just goes from resource to resource, just strip mining it.
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm envisioning, stuff like that. A lot of just decimating regions to rip out every last mineral that they can grab.
Yeah,
kind of stuff. That's their primary, like, nasty activity, probably, although all the pollution and just... And lots of political. They own a lot of politicians. They drive lots of media. You know, lots of... They've got their green energy tech, and they're massive in that, too. They've got solar and wind and all that stuff. Anything that can make them money.
It wouldn't surprise me if your company... well, obviously contracts out to Gekido, but also... Oh, yeah. In part, uses Shinhan's media connections.
Probably.
Oh, looks like we might have our player joining, certainly.
I could see them contracting out Kikido to go into, like, some South American country and just wipe out a village so they can go and strip mine it kind of stuff, you know?
Interesting. Right. I like the kind of web that's growing out of all these companies that, you know, Alpha X is poking at Shinhan, but probably also has their own media corporation that's kind of, you know, showing off to be like, no, our thing is the perfect thing. You want this white-walled, multicolor, fascinating VR experience from Alpha X. You don't want that... Someone's gonna break my setup in a second here.
Yay.
Sorry, Fig. I gotta kick you now.
Bye. You can stay on the call.
Well, except I fucks up all the video.
Oh.
So. Bye. There we go. I didn't realize it was gonna make a six array in a second here. All right. It should load. There we go. Garturt's in his square, where he belongs.
Yep, that's. Yeah, sorry guys, I didn't mean to come in this late.
No worries. We're working our way through making corporations right now. We haven't even touched characters as of yet.
Oh, sweet.
So, to catch you up, for starters, we're doing the setting as kind of California plus a offshore arcology that's basically the greater city of Tokyo, and then probably a bridging thereof between them. Is gotcha. Going to be the main focus of locations. I'm going to explore deeper locations with you guys in a second. The companies that have been created so far are my own, which is Alpha X, which is a combination of Google and SpaceX, basically, because Elon Musk has basically made every cyberpunk company you could think of, and Google is basically the mega corporation of now, and I thought the two together worked beautifully. We have Gekido Prime, which is Jim's corporation, which is security, legal retrieval, but has deeper roots in things like bounty hunting, black ops, starting wars, toppling corporations, and it's run by a familial dynasty. The board is, well, the CEO's probably father-daughter combination, I assume. I don't want to cut too much into it, but with the boards being other wider family member. And then Shane's is Shinhan Financial, which is a banking company first and foremost, but it does general goods, it does smaller low-level tech, it does housing, it does, it's the, I don't have a good modern company to compare it to, but
yeah, the U.S. doesn't have a lot of companies like this, but it was pretty common in Korea.
Plastered everywhere kind of company. But it deals above board in that style of general goods, tech, and housing, and below board with things like propaganda, money laundering, investing, subprime mortgage, reinvesting, etc. So, money moves through Shinhan Financial, which with financial in M, you'd kind of expect that. Yeah. And then we have our great heavy industry company that is currently unnamed, that's Wills. It's anything from asteroid mining, strip mining, power generation, probably big on the not really caring about the environment, but still plays the, oh, we care about the environment. Look at all this awesome things we've done. In a nice little presentation they show everyone while they're strip mining their backyard.
And I think I just came up with a name.
Oh, I'm all for that. Let's hear it.
It'll be TEPCO Dow. TEPCO is the Tokyo Electric Power Company.
Oh, I know TEPCO.
TEPCO hyphen Dow, Dow Chemical. They've come together in the future to create
D-A-O
this
D-A-O or D-A-W?
D-O-W.
D-O- oh, that Dow. Okay.
That Dow, yeah. Dow Chemical. They've come together to create this massive energy heavy industry conglomerate.
That's terrifying.
Yeah.
I have now officially created TEPCO Dow Chem Industry.
There you go.
When you get a sec, if you look in the Sprawl folder, you'll see a folder that says company logos.
Oh.
So I did a quick PNG for Keto Prime that you should be able to shrink down, kind of like your Alpha X one.
Company logos. Ooh, I like. Cool. All right, let's get
I'll have
this.
To come up with something. You guys I might tweak the name so it's not exactly the real names, but
oh, that's what having I'm having exactly the real names does not bother me in the slightest. Don't worry about that.
What folder are you guys looking at? Because I am
the Dropbox, the Sprawl folder I added you to recently that has the mood pictures in it.
Gotcha.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, frickin' hell. Advanced. Where's his drawing? Welcome to my. Editing as I go along here. No promises I'm going to get the aspect ratio right, but I will aim to get it as close as possible.
Well, that's pretty close.
Having logos makes it set easier. Nicely. I'm going to rename your thing here. TEPCO Dow Chem Industry. Can't wait to see that logo. That logo is going to be fun to make. Alright.
Yep, that'll be fun.
From there, let's add another set of dashes here and go to the late man in the stream here. Garrett, what is your corporation?
So I've been thinking about like a genetic modification corporation.
Ooh.
Like a company like striving to achieve, you know, to true perfection in humanity, you know, like kind of slightly rivaling all the cybernetic stuff that's been popping up recently, mm-hmm. or, you know, have recently been going on. They're like, no, let's not augment ourselves. Let's make ourselves perfect.
Hmm.
That's kind of like their goal, their dream. And, crap, I had a name for it. Genetifix.
Genetifix. Nice. I like it. So... what kind of modifications have they made so far? Like, what have they made to go, oh, this is better than putting technology in your body?
They, through the genetic modification research, they have, like, cured a whole bunch of diseases so far. Like, right now, they're in the public eye, they're more of, like, a glorified medical research place, but like they have bigger ambitions to, you know, like make humans stronger, smarter, faster, without the need of, you know, lopping off body parts and replacing it with cybernetics.
I'm envisioning something along the lines of they don't use Gekido for their security, because their security are these genetically modified, like, massive dudes.
Yeah. Like, yeah, that's
They have a bunch of Arnold Schwarzeneggers running around as their security force.
Yeah, it's pretty intense.
I like it. Sounds like a fussy baby. I might have to go help her.
Okay, no worries.
In a minute, we'll see if she calms down.
What is the most... like, what is their biggest, what is their title item that they've made so far? Like, what is their showcase? When you think of Genetifix, you think of...
as of right now, you think of a, I don't even know what it'd be. It'd just be, like, a genetic augmentation that makes you, like, your base, it bolsters your immune system, so it's almost impossible to get sick. It's expensive as hell, but once you have it, like, for the rest of your life, you're good.
I would say that would be extremely expensive.
Yes.
Welcome to the 1% of 1% of 1%.
Mm-hmm.
No problem. All right. So, whilst I get back to running this here. So, the biggest principle of this game is to chrome everything and then make it dirty. That's the basic ideals of Cyberpunk. Cyberpunk is the future where we've made all this fancy tech, but y'all are oppressed and it sucks to be at the bottom floor.
Yeah.
The biggest thing here in second in the principle is begin and end with the fiction. Basically, you have moves in this game. They're moves like harm and whatever they're called. I have the move list here. Player moves. Act under pressure, hit the street, research. But the goal will be more of you telling me, I want to reach out to my my main contact and be like, hey, I'm looking for this piece of information. And then I will tell you, okay, you hit the street, roll dice. Or I'm going to jump out behind this guy before he knows I'm there and then shoot him in the back of the head. And then I'll be like, okay, that will be, I would say, mix it up. Because it sounds, use violence against an armed force to seize control of an objective. You actually have to state the objective, but it's going to be more of, you're going to be telling me the actions you do, and I will be applying it rather than you go, oh, I'm going to mix it up. Just, the aim is more to show the action rather than show the behind the scenes, and then I'll have you roll the dice. I'm going to be trying to address you guys as your character names more than anything else. I'm going to be asking you lots of questions. Every time you have an action, anytime you want to explore a thing, sometimes you'll be like, what is the security in a certain site? I'll be like, you tell me. Explain the security to me. That'll put a lot of the onus on you guys, but we're going to be building the story together, so it's going to be give and take on both of there. Everything's going to have a name. We've got these corporations that you're building out that all have different names. Every piece of technology you have is going to be a name. If you have a gun, don't call it my 9mm. You call it your, your wind Glock, burstinator or something. Give it a name. Make it real. Everything is going to be based on these corporations. We're probably going to expand more eventually, but the five that we have right now are going to be the key ones. Complications are going to arise. It'll definitely get personal with your guys' backgrounds once we explore that, so expect that coming your way. NPCs are going to come and go. They're all going to have names, but some of them might just get wasted. And overall, the key principle of this game is be a fan of the characters. It's your guys' story. It's going to be mission-based, so it's going to be kind of crammed into what you guys are working together for, but that's going to be the big thing. I highly recommend you look through this section, which is the how it's run, to get an idea of how I'm going to be picking at it. What was the one thing I was looking for here? Excuse me while I do this very riveting reading through a book here. So, going back to our city, we've kind of covered the fact that it's, I would say, probably most of Northern California, plus a huge kind of offshore island group with Tokyo, the Alpha X headquarters, which probably also doubles as a rocket launching. So you'll probably be like, oh, you're looking over the city and you see a rocket launch out of the ocean. Tell me about other important areas of this city.
Ah. How far in the future is this?
Indeterminate enough that they have arcologies and rocket launches are fairly regular, and there's cyberware, and the internet's basically virtual reality, but I'm not really going to give a year, so we can have as much tech or as little tech as you guys kind of want to explore.
Gotcha.
Kind of want to have an area of the city that is what's the best way it is? I kind of want a small area of the city that is basically emergent AI life forms, basically robots and stuff that are kind of, they're kind of pooling together in a small area of the city. It's referred to as like Cybertown or something, where these
do you see it as more of like they're the higher society, or more of like they're the outcast kind of, like it's the ghetto, it's the AI ghetto?
Well, depends on how we're doing AI in this. Since most AIs are going to be in like large, I assume, like the one that runs Alpha X is probably a huge mainframe of some sort. It's probably not very mobile.
Yeah, I kind of see this maybe as, maybe AI is borderline illegal, so it is more of a hidden ghetto, maybe.
Yeah.
One of the things I was trying to incorporate, if you've ever looked up, what is it called? Kowloon Walled City. If you've ever seen that, I could totally see that being Cybertown, which is basically multiple city blocks where they just kept building and building and building, and it was just like warrens of tunnels and multi-story. Yeah. If you ever want the coolest thing ever to look up that, because, oh my god.
Yeah, that's kind of the way I envision it, is that it's the AIs trying to stay off, you know, it's these AIs that are banding together for security and safety, but they're also trying to stay off the radar so that, you know, that they don't, they're not, one, they don't appear to be a threat, but two, they have each other in case somebody decides to take notice.
Yeah. I definitely like that, and that sounds super... like it's gonna be, I'm almost envisioning like the Cybertown has its own like gang that's trying to start to poke its way into becoming legitimate.
Mm-hmm. And if you need anything, like if you're looking for something AI, you're looking for something computer related or that type of thing, you know, you probably know a guy who knows a guy who is in Cybertown.
Yeah.
You know, and I can even see there being like, you know, like they've taken over bars in the, they've taken over a bar in the area, and even though they serve, you know, organics as they'll call them or whatever, you know, the owner is an AI of some sort, the bartender's an AI, you know, and talks about how his measurements are precise and exact, and you know, you stupid organics, you know, don't know how to measure or whatever.
Yeah.
Not that they're creating a AI versus versus organic strife. There's just very clear that they're different.
Yeah.
That.
On that same note, and this is something I was wondering and probably should have explored while we were discussing it, but with Gekido Prime, are they headquartered in this Metroplex? I'm gonna have to come up with a great name for this, but For the time being, it is the
we call it San Fran Tokyo Bay or something.
Let's do San Fran Tokyo Metroplex for the time being, until I can magic up something further. Where is Gekido housed in this Metroplex, or is it just a regional office here?
I think it's probably housed in this area. You know, basically it grew up with the, it grew from the same stems that grew, you know, the Tokyo Island and all that.
So it's more Tokyo Island than it is Bay Area.
Right, like its headquarters is probably, it probably has a primary small headquarters on Tokyo Island, but it probably has a big grand, like, facade building, you know, basically to make it look like their primary headquarters is in the bay, is on the bay side. But in reality, they have a secure headquarters on Tokyo Island.
Real/secure, and then front HQ on Bay Area side. Awesome. And then I will go back to Shinhan in a moment. Oh, wait. No, Shinhan's next. Where is Shinhan headquartered?
I think they're probably on the Bay side. I think that originally they were probably like a foreign national company, so they weren't originally like American, but they had established themselves mostly. But then they have like, you know, little regional, like divisional, and like for each like division is somewhere smaller, right? So like,
so,
like,
so this is this department, so is, the Bay Area side might actually, instead of being the headquarter, might actually be a regional headquarters.
Well, no, I was thinking the Bay Area one. This is their like financial headquarters for like the main company.
Okay. So,
Bay and then Area they probably side. Have like, this is their big shiny tower. But they have, you know, I'm sure they have smaller buildings for their home division or like their real estate development section. And then of course, they, you know, they have neighborhood little, like, banks where the poor people can come and deposit their, like, $5 a day.
Yeah, they're the generic ATMs around the city.
But those, like, would be, like, small, just, like...
Like phone booth-level ATMs.
Yeah. Or, like, these rooms where it's just all ATMs, and you can come in and, like, withdraw your money, and there's, like, 100 people inside just at ATMs, but...
Yeah. I also kind of see... the city kind of broken down into, you have like the downtowns, which are probably these like grand awesome buildings where Gekido's Bay Area headquarters is, where Shinhan's shiny tower is, and then you have like green zones, which are, you know, the rich people walled off. I live in suburbia within the biggest city in the world, basically, style. I would bet there's a kind of one green zone in the Tokyo Island that's all, like, the richest of rich people living in the green zone, and then everything else is just, like, interconnected, crazy-looking buildings of just sprawl nastiness.
I've always liked the tiered city concept.
Yeah.
Which is could be fun, especially I could see that for the this Tokyo offshoot, since they only had a limited space, they probably continue to build up.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that, where the Bay Area probably has green zones for building out, the Tokyo side has green zones for building up. Like, anything above level 12 is a green zone. You must have, like, $6 million in your bank account to be able to go above this level.
Yeah, kind of stuff. And it has its own plazas and whatnot above it. It's all built above, streets above, all that kind of stuff.
I have a question.
Yeah.
There's a lot of waterfront in this area. This is like Bay Area, San Francisco, and Bay Area, Tokyo. Is the waterfront like nice and shiny and like rich people live there because there's ocean view, or is it like gross and slummy because it's industrial docking and there's pollution and...
I would say in that bridge between, say, San Francisco and Tokyo, where the Alpha X headquarters acts like, for lack of a better term, passport control, but not really, between the two, that is pretty. Beyond that, I would say shipping and ugly. Like, it's where TEPCO Dow has their docking facilities for all of their strip mining rigs and their massive... cargo barges show up to drop off, you know, all the crap that, you know, Shinhan uses to build their stuff and Alpha X uses to build their stuff.
I can see almost like holographic walls that are along the bridge a little ways out, so you don't actually see all that.
Oh,
as
yeah.
You're walking along, or especially around the headquarters.
Totally.
So it looks like just paradise, but if the reality is just nasty.
Yeah, you don't want to look beyond the wall. Mm-hmm. You're the rich person who wants to live in the fantasy of, oh, I live in this, like, what's the word I'm looking for? Tropical paradise as I walk out onto my deck versus, oh, I walk that 5 steps beyond my deck and realize, I need to turn around and walk back.
Yep.
It wouldn't surprise me if actually most of it looks like crap and it's all just plastered over with augmented reality. Like, you probably at birth were given an augment implant into your eye because that's like the government requirement. You need to be able to see all the ads that Alpha X and Shinhan are pushing at you, but it also makes you see the everything else that is the world. Right. Either anyone else want to add like different other sections of the city?
I was kind of thinking, like, in regards to Genifix, like, kind of, like, where their HQ is.
Mm-hmm.
I was thinking around, is like, it's, like, almost, like, in the clouds, like, how high their towers are. Because that's, like, the 1% of the 1% that gets to, you know, use, like, Genifix products. And I was kind of thinking about, like, in, like, how, like, people, like, you know, the common folk call it almost, like, heaven. Because everyone there looks like an angel. Like, everyone there looks perfect. Like, you know, because you have all the genetic modification, you know, it's made them extremely attractive. Yeah. Oh, yeah, Elysium.
Yeah.
So, is their main Ultra Tower in Central Bay Area or Central Tokyo? Oops, as I knocked my mic.
I'd say Central Bay Area.
Okay. I'll call that a Mega Tower. Elysium-like. That would be, I'm envisioning like this. I'm trying to avoid the Trump Tower style, stylings, but probably more like what's the one in Dubai?
Oh,
the spire that I can't remember the name of, with like ring facilities around it, kinda. Like you have ultra centrifuges around layers of your building. Cool. All right. I think we're starting to get a view of this city here, and my music's actually starting to get a little bit loud. Where's my music? Music. Dial it down a little bit more here. All right. So we'll probably expand it more. Especially once we start digging into your characters. But I guess that gonna bring us on to the next step. Kazuntite. Yeah, you're muted, but I still saw it anyways. Alright. So, I guess I will start in order of left to right on the screens at the bottom. Let's just start with what playbook are you guys going for, and then you guys can hash it out if you guys have overlapping playbooks here.
Okay. I was kind of leaning towards killer, but my other two choices would be hacker and infiltrator.
Killer, hacker, infiltrator. Anyone else wanting to be a killer?
Not me.
Well, I guess if you want to be killer works. I love that one.
I do too. It's, I mean, just what I've read of it, it's really cool.
It's funny the dichotomy between killer and soldier. You assume soldier's going to be just like killer in that he's there to kill things. But no, the soldier's actually there to lead.
Mm-hmm.
You can build him to be good at killing things, but he'll never be as good as the killer.
Yeah.
It's right there in the name, man.
Yeah.
Jim, what are you looking to do?
I'm liking Fixer.
Ooh.
That's cool, too.
I was hoping we'd get a Fixer. Well, anyone else? Also,
I think it's something that I could play fairly easily, just looking at it.
Well, it reminds me of your character from our Star Wars game.
Yeah.
He was basically a Fixer. What?
Yeah, a little bit.
Fixer hacker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was anyone else aiming to be a fixer?
Again. I'll be back in a sec.
Yep, no problem. Shane, what were you looking to do?
I was looking at the pusher.
Ooh. I still don't have a good feel for pusher, so I'm very eager to explore precisely
how you I've got a couple different ideas floating around depending on how things kind of come together.
Nice. And yes, thank you, Fig, the Burj Khalifa, looking back 3 minutes ago. Awesome. And then Garrett.
Man, I'm trying to decide between Hunter and Infiltrator.
Ooh. Do you want to sneak into things more, or do you want to find people more?
Exactly. That's the question, man. That's the question.
Well, like I said, I'm going to be tailoring this to you guys' specialities. I'm kind of glad no one picked Reporter, because with a killer and a pusher, I think having a Reporter might be difficult. But,
I changed my mind. I'm going to be a Reporter.
I hate your face.
Kid, I kid.
Uh-huh.
The only thing I was actually looking at if I couldn't have done Fixer was...
I mean, theoretically, it wouldn't be too difficult. It would just be complicated.
I was looking at either Soldier or Tech, actually, was the others I was looking at. So. Yeah.
And then noting we don't have a hacker, so just be ready for probably having to hire your way into sneaking into things with the technical side of things.
What? Which, Garrett didn't take Hacker?
Nope. Garrett is torn between Infiltrator and Hunter.
Garrett, you're letting me down, man.
Hey, man. Sorry, it's not where my heart is.
Oh. He doesn't want to hack with the grandma blanket behind him.
Exactly, man. Hey, come on, man.
I did notice your camera angles changed. You're down a little more level now. We're seeing more of the wall and less of the floor.
Yeah, the lighting's a lot better, too.
Oh, shucks. Well, it's also because I have a new monitor that's just blasting white light on my face, so... Yeah.
That'll do.
I think we're going to go Hunter.
Awesome. It's going to be an interesting combination, these four. I like it. So, now that we have the basics going on here, let me get my reference sheet of awesome.
Hey, Garrett, have you logged into the Roll20 to see, or the Twitch stream to see the overlay?
Oh, yeah, I am. Yeah, oh, I can see a little guard turret.
Oh, good. You did, I gotta link your character to you. Edit. Alright, Garrett. You have added access to your character now, so you're welcome to play around with it.
Yeah, I've been looking for a portrait for my character, but I haven't been able to find one.
Going back here, blah, 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 blah. So... You don't have to dig up a name just yet, but if you have a name, let me know, and feel free to rename your character sheet while you're at it. And then you have the, in the playbooks, they have different descriptor options. You are not limited to those, but they are thematically pretty sound. I should actually probably open them up for my own reference. Company logos. If anyone on the stream is interested, if you Google the Sprawl and playbooks, you'll be able to actually look at all these character sheets as well. I'll be showing each character sheet as we go along, too. Where's my list here? Killer. I gotta wait for him to come back anyway, so we'll go back to Fixer. Okay, I guess the description options aren't actually in the playbook. They are in the actual book. Yep, if you go to the main book, page 75, it has the choose your look, eyes, face, body, wear, skin, and then it'll give you stat numbers.
Yep, I see it. I'm on there.
Cool. And for everyone, whilst we're kind of looking over that stuff too, your stats are pretty simple. Style, meat, edge, mind, cool, and synth. Going backwards from that, synth is your ability to use technology. Cool. Where am I?
We lost Garrett, by the way.
Yeah, what? Garrett, where'd you go?
Yay,
I have 9 viewers. All the faces be broken. Where did my stats go?
Okay.
Pick up with their name, by the way.
Oh, nice.
We lose Gardert.
Yes, we lost Gardert.
Question, is he coming back?
That's a good question. Okay. Did he log off of, when did you send me the 750? Oh,
no, regards, or regarders.
Where's my music?
I'm also seeing all the timers all scrambled on the thing, but I don't. That's
timer scramble on the thing.
Yeah, on the, for me on the page, like the Keto Prime doesn't have anything behind it. Everything's kind of stacked up at the bottom. I don't know what the hell that.
I mean,
yeah.
Hmm.
Hold on, let me refresh the editor here.
Drum
roll, refreshing.
So what did I miss? Who picked what? I know you were thinking Fixer. Did anybody else go yet?
So our list is as follows. You are the killer. Jim is the fixer. Shane is a pusher. And Garrett is a hunter.
Nice. Okay.
So we have no hacker. So that'll make life interesting. Y'all are going to have to get through tech some other way. How can I fix this here?
Yeah, that, you had an image in your, image folder that really inspired me towards Killer. It's that one with him standing over the dead body at the screen.
Nice!
I love that. That was like, oh god, I want that. That's what I want to play.
Where's my, I vaguely remember that here. Let's see if I can find it again. The one with the... Yeah! Dude,
it's the fourth one in the folder.
Yep.
The Van... The Vulcan cover-up.
And amusingly, it looks like he shot a dude who works for, TEPCO Dow.
Yeah. Kinda does, doesn't it?
Because he's looking at the screen with what looks like an oil rig on it.
Yep.
Alright, Garrett, where'd you go?
So what do base stats start at?
Base stats start at, you'll see it in your page. It's, you get, let's see, fixer.
Well, it says 2, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, minus 1.
Yes, so those will be your stats.
But what do I start at, 0?
Yes, everything is 0. So well, the way Apocalypse World works, well, Powered by the Apocalypse works, is, or at least this way, you roll 2d6, 6 and below is a failure, where I get to do something. 7 through 9 is a partial success, and 10 plus is a success. Like, a success, a perfect success, basically. So, if you're rolling the stat with a minus 1, you're going to be rolling 2d6 minus 1. So you're going to be very good at the things that you have at plus 2, and you're going to be less good at the things you have at minus 1. I'm looking at driver. Where's fixer? I think everyone gets plus 2, plus 1, plus 1, plus 0, and minus 1. If I remember correctly. Yep. You get one at two, two at one, two at zero, and one at minus one.
I'm gonna have to go here in a couple minutes, guys. Leah's home, and we're gonna do dinner.
Cool. Hi, Leah.
Hi.
You guys here?
Yep. Hello.
So,
you gotta come show them your hair. I haven't seen your haircut.
We might have to do
a. Get the band back together.
We might have to do an episode 0.2. Hi, Leah. Your hair looks amazing.
Nice.
I know, doesn't it? She looks great with her short hair.
See if I can't at least even up our screens for the time being, and then come on, show me my. I want to hide my camera. There we go.
Okay.
And then mute audio.
So I will work on fleshing out my character. I've done my stats. I don't know if you want to look at them.
Okay. Yeah, I can open up your character right now. Character sheet.
You can see my name.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. Great. Got it, bed.
That for is a fixer. Funny. I approve. That is awesome.
All right, she's really hollering, so I may need to drop off too.
No worries. Well,
yeah, let's plan a 0.2 for character, the actual character development, because we did a lot of city building and stuff tonight.
Yeah,
too.
We built our universe pretty effectively this evening, and I'll probably kind of flesh out a little bit further. Just do your looks and your stats, and if you can drum up with a picture of your character, even added better. That big bonus there, Jim. You'll probably want to replace the Johnny Bravo picture that you've got in there right now.
Mama.
And then I will explore the why you have tech in you. I have a bunch of questions for you when we start digging into our characters further. So get the stats in place and kind of think of certain answers for why you're either owned or...
So can I suggest that we do I'll throw up a Trello board and we can start fleshing out like our locations and our characters, and we'll just have cards for all the stuff so that we can kind of have a shared resource in a common location. It's easy to
do that.
Yeah, sounds good.
Does everybody have a Trello account?
I think I do.
I have used it before.
It's free, so go to Trello.com if you have one. Send me a username and I'll add you to the board. Trello.
Yep.
Trello. Throw it in Discord and I'll add you, and then we'll get Garrett when he turns back up. But we did this for our Dresden game, and it made it real easy to flesh out like corporations and companies and and where things crisscrossed. We had a reference point for the GM to look at to build stories from. But that way it was in one place.
Yep. Sounds good.
Hey, Jonathan, are you coming? PAX Unplugged?
Yes, I have tickets for it. I have not booked anything else yet, though.
If you need, I think we currently have a... We could set up to have a... Do you want to share a room?
That's a distinct maybe. I'm still working on whether or not Andrea wants to go, and once that's decided...
We can share. I mean, it would make it a little cheaper if you guys are okay sharing a room with another couple.
Yeah, it shouldn't be a problem.
We're at the Hampton Inn across the street from the convention center.
Nice.
It's behind the convention center, but I think there's a walkway over.
Well, regardless, it will be at least me with an extra ticket, or me and her, and she's just going to be touring the city whilst I'm being a nerd, so we'll see.
I think you should talk her into coming, because there's going to be a bunch of other couples, like our friend Danetta and Tomas, me and Leah, Jenny and Chip, so I think she will... Yeah, I think she'll... I think she'd find it more appealing, since it's not... It's nerdy, but not too nerdy, because it's board games.
Yeah.
Let's do. Cool. But sorry, I didn't mean to derail the conversation, guys.
I know that's perfectly fine. So yeah. I might as well close this out here. Thank you for watching us make a world here and slowly build out interesting characters, which we'll be doing next week in theory if everyone's available. I am Steel Seraph here on Twitch, if you haven't worked that out by being in my channel. I'm also Steel Seraph on Twitter and pretty much everywhere else, including YouTube, which I will probably be uploading this to. I'm going to be streaming a little bit more often, depending on availability on my other nights. I'm especially once Destiny comes out, my goal is to stream a whole lot more, so that's coming. Will, tell everyone about yourself, where they can follow you, what they can do.
What is my Twitter handle these days? I can't even remember. I'm DustKid on here, though I don't do any streaming currently. Blank stare. It will be my. I think it'll be my character, and we'll figure that out. That's coming. That'll be something for me. I'm Blanks821 on Twitter.
And blank stare would sound so much better on Twitter.
Yeah, you're not wrong. I may have to make a blank stare account if that's available. Probably isn't. We'll have to check. But yeah, that's about it. Not really active, but I'll be on here. So come see me here.
Sorry about that.
Jim,
still recovering from the con plague I got at Gen Con. I'm VidWizard, VIDD, VIDD Wizard. I always have to specify that, otherwise they put 2Ds in Wizard. or they go, there are 2Ds in VidWizard. I'm like, no, there's two. Never mind. yeah, it's a fun debate to have with people. I don't stream a whole lot other than when I'm playing with these guys. Great to see these guys. Nice to be Shane. It's great to see Will and Garrett again. I don't care what that other guy who shall not be named, you know, Voldemort, says. These are, you're a great bunch of guys to play with, and I'm really glad that we're getting back into something. So, and I will turn it over to Shane.
Yeah, you can't find me anywhere. I'm hidden, so good luck with that.
Well, awesome. That works.
And the invisible frame is Garrett or Garter.
Garrett.
No regards. No regards.
No regards.
He's Garter. Garter.
Garter. French. My name is Garter. No, you know, instead of no regrets, it's no regarrets.
If I remember correctly, he is Why Am I Not a Jedi on Twitter.
Yes.
And he is Platinum Nova here on Twitch. So
the Platinum Nova.
Yeah, that's it. So feel free to throw follows out and shoot mean, nasty messages about disappearing halfway through character generation in the stream. We'll be back here next Wednesday, hopefully a little bit more on time at 6:30. And I'm looking forward to streaming again, and I apologize in advance. I'm a new GM, so be gentle.
Oh, sorry.
Wait.
Hold on. Where's my thing? I need to switch it to a thing. Where's OBS? Oh, I'm staring at OBS. Derp. Derp. Bye.